Commodore, I've got a bogey bearing 290.
IFF?
Negative, sir.
Scope me.
It's a hammerhead.
Still closing. Zero target aspect.
All our birds are accounted for, and there's no other ships in the region.
Any intelligence reports of chicks flying captured SA-43s?
He's headed right for us.
Could be a silicate suicide bomber.
Deny it. Warn him.
Unidentified spacecraft off my port bow. You're approaching the U.S. naval carrier Saratoga. Request you alter course and identify yourself immediately. He's still coming, sir.
Fire a warning shot.
2.69er off the port bow.
2.69er off the port bow, aye aye.
Commodore, it's overridden the HPDL. It's docking.
Security alert. Master of arms late to the third deck.
Canopy.
Boy, don't ever play with guns, but I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die.
He's dead.
When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry.
Kind of a bummer getting your butt kicked by a dead guy.
Butts, Raymond Thomas. My rank is Lieutenant Colonel. 924-715-8437.
You're not a prisoner of war, Colonel.
No, Colonel, but I've been a POW. Back in 52, Karakoram. CC's tortured me for 3 straight days.
How did you override the hangar bay door lock?
And I never talked.
I was on the bridge. It wasn't activated on our end.
I would advise an immediate investigation of the HBDL.
Where are your men?
My men are my business.
They're the Corps' business. You recon?
If I were, I would not be at liberty to address that question.
But I'm not out to bust you. Joined the Corps at 20. Never married. Week out of the Space Aviators Academy in Loxley, you were in Quantico Officers Candidate School, top of the class. 2 silver stars in Guatemala. Special forces in the AI rebellion. We're 2 lifers. You got nothing to hide.
Forget the butter, McQueen. Maybe we do have the same amount of time in. Maybe we wear the same ribbons from our nipples when we put on the dress blues. But don't you think for 1 second that we are equals, Tank.
You're hiding something. You screwed up, didn't you?
Ray Butts never screws up.
I think Ray Butts did. I think men got hurt under your command and you won't come clean.
Think what you want, but you don't know squat.
Then why don't you tell me something? Like how you got here and why?
Check out how close this Chig missile burn is.
Assume he was in a serious hand-to-hand furball.
Now look at this. The man in black.
Who's the man in black?
These readouts indicate that this plane was on the border of the Cerberus black hole.
That's Never Never Country.
The optical disc playback should show the flight history.
Hey!
You touch that ODP, you'll be wearing your bra backwards after I twist you in half. Hey, hey. Look at Loverboy. I think he's got it in his mind to strike a senior officer. Come on. Come on. Let's go, Romeo. Come on. Come on. Don't let your better judgment stop you now.
Sir, we were just...
Hey, man. You're touching me like you love me. Do you love me? Well, hey, man. I love you. Maybe we should get married. Huh? Maybe you should propose to me. Hey... Why don't you get down on one knee and ask for my hand? Oh, my God. Another nipple, Nick. This bucket's crawling with him. Hey, hey, hey. Oh, hey. The 58th. Hold up. You silver bars are the 58th? Wild cards? Oh, my. You stopped the chigs at the Battle of the Belt. That was you? Oh, man. I heard of you. Hell. Well, I didn't know what I was expecting, but it ain't you. Chigs must not have wanted it that day. You can take on the entire Chig army, but let me advise you to stay clear of me.
How come you just can't punch a senior officer? Like if he's got it coming.
Butts couldn't have made Lieutenant Colonel if he was just some long-gone hard charger.
Oh, man. That guy is one Colonel Semper Psycho.
If Foose is right, you guys are overdoing it just because he gave you jalapeno enema.
Maybe. Just, you know, no one is born that mean. They either put it on for effect or something happened, something turned them that mean. They can never go back. The worst part is, they know it.
My name's Macbeth. The devil himself could not pronounce a title more hateful to mine ear.
No, no more.
Isn't this great? I requested it at the beginning of our tour. It took 3 months to get it.
I don't know what this guy's saying, but he means it.
Come on!
Damned armed force sensors. We can kill chigs, we can earn medals, but we can't watch a fight on TV.
Pop the V-chip.
Come on, just in time. Hey, you idiot! What the hell do you think you're doing?
I saw what you maggots did. Brass says you're not supposed to see this crap.
May I speak freely, Colonel?
Speak.
You don't care if we see this. You're just messing with our heads. Being at war, this could be the last time I hear Shakespeare, and you took that from me. And if you weren't wearing those oak leaves, sir, I'd be kicking your ass up between your shoulder blades.
I'll tell you what. I'll drop these oak leaves for just 10 seconds. Because that's all it'll take to pound some respect into you. Keep the knife. It'll make things even.
Okay, all right.
Oh!
I want you gone.
I don't know how or why you're here or what you think you're doing with my people. Abusing subordinates, disrupting morale and unity. Whatever you're doing, I take one look at you and know that it's only about you. And anyone pulled in is gonna die while you just drive on.
They all passed my test. They all came running to help their buddies. You taught them real good.
Don't butter me. You are gone. I don't care if you turn out to be the Commodore's bestest golf buddy and you bleed scarlet and gold. You are gone! I will pull every string to get you away from my people and off this bucket and back to the slime pit you crawled out of.
Well, maybe you can pull every string, but I pull the rope. I'm on a mission, classified, compartmentalized, and I'm taking them with me. Of course, they're not the caliber that I'm used to working with, but that might not matter. I gotta go when the tide wanes on the Cerberus black hole.
This ain't gonna happen.
I'm in this so deep, so dark. The old man approves anything I request, including this. So deal with it. You are no longer in command of the 58th. They're mine now.
Because you're mine, I walk the line.
In the back.
Because you didn't cover it. Where'd he go?
Sorry, Coop. I'm dead.
Come on, I think you're on your last breath. That deck's unsecured. It's out of bounds.
I know.
Oh, Coop. Butts is breaking his own rules, huh?
That's cheap. I ain't going out like this.
Really, you wouldn't be able to bitch, so shut up.
Thank you.
Easy as eating pancakes.
Cheap. They were all cheap kills.
He won't have any dishwashers to hide behind in the thick.
I don't get the point. He's supposed to be training us to use the skills he knows, not showing them off.
Exactly. Felt like he was just using us to sharpen his skills. We were clay pigeons.
Maybe he was trying to lead by example.
Not much of a leader.
I'm in a squad where I'd rather shoot the CO than the enemy.
Knock it off.
You know what I'm saying, sir. I mean, I never felt like shooting you.
Stop it, Hawks. You're making me all misty.
Sir, we'd all lay down our lives for you because we know you'd put down for us. But...
He wouldn't be there.
Sir, is there something you can do?
We don't want him. We want you.
This isn't a dating service. We're in the middle of a war. If we stop following orders, there will be no order. It'll all fall apart.
Sir, would you follow him into a firefight?
He's an officer in the Corps, trained to care about his Marines. And yes, if so ordered, I would follow him. But I'd watch my six. And I'd watch each other's sixes. Real close.
Maybe we won't have to worry about it. After the way we performed today, Butts probably won't want us to follow him.
I try to make believe there's nothing wrong, but they're always asking me about you, darling. And it hurts me so to tell them that you're gone. If they asked me, I guess I'd be denied that I've been unhappy all along. But if they hurt my heart, they'd hear it cry.
I was wondering if you still want us for the mission after
Where's
today.
Where's my darling when she coming home?
Most of the units I trained eat it in 5 minutes. You all lasted 10.
What do you think about in the dark?
I think about the first man I ever killed.
What about him?
I wonder what he's doing now. And if he got the better end of the deal. I understand your folks were in the Corps. AI's got him.
Sometimes I think my father'd be about your age.
One lonely hour. At least he died for something.
What would you die for?
But I guess I'll keep waiting till you're with
me. Sir.
'Cause I believe that loving you is right.
I know you'd kill for us.
But I don't care.
Would you die for us?
If I can't have you with me tonight. Well, I know I'll keep on.
I'm already dead, Vanson.
Love can't be killed. I ought to get you off of my mind, but I guess I never will.
Tell him to hit the rack. We ship off at 0130.
Still, 'cause I get so doggone lonesome.
Tell us exactly what our mission is. What? Did he tell you something?
No. It's just... It sounds like he's not planning on coming back.
Well, is he planning on us coming back?
Danby. Parachutes. We're making a drop.
Supply secured. Load up.
Thank you.
Butts. I know they're not my children. They're Marines. Life takers and heartbreakers. And I know we're at war and people die. But if any of my people die because of you, all your recon skills and black ops training won't be worth a damn. I'll find you.
Listen up. You are participating in Operation Get Rhythm. The objective is to retrieve 6 SA-43 attack jets, currently camoed deep in enemy territory.
How'd they get there?
And return them safely to the Saratoga. To achieve optimum stealth, deployment will be made via high-altitude, low-opening parachute drop. ISS CV exit will be at 30,000 feet. Shoot deployment will commence at 2,000 feet.
We haven't been trained for a halo jump.
Same as a regular jump. You just wait longer.
A hell of a lot longer.
It's as easy as eating pancakes. On your feet! Step up to the hatch. Heads up! We will meet at 30 degrees, 5 minutes, by 75 degrees, 2 minutes, at 0634. That'll be just after sunrise. It is presently 0600. Ready? Ready? Heck! What are you worried about? It's dark. You won't even know you're falling 28,000 feet.
Let's go. What are you doing?
I'm waiting for my testicles. They should be dropping in any second.
If I were Tig, I'd be burying you now.
Sir, what are the coordinates of the hammerheads?
I've changed the initial objective.
You've changed it? What's the call?
Classified.
Classified? There's 6 of us in Chig territory. You think there's gonna be a breach of security?
We want to see the orders you're under, Colonel.
We don't believe this new objective is an authorized mission.
A leader can't worry about every order getting the once over.
You're the one who said you didn't think he was planning on coming back.
You tell us the assignment.
All right. Vance and West, stash the mount out box. The rest of you cover them. Last thing we need is an ambush. Then we'll meet back here. And you will be briefed.
gone. He left us here.
What do we do now? He's our only way out of here.
Big footprint.
West. We just found some bushes he passed through. Alter your position 25 meters east.
Doing?
Looks like he's planning some kind of explosive charge.
Maybe he's caching equipment.
Whoa. Over here, I found a body.
Did you kill this man?
They're all dead. Because of me. In my life, I've killed hundreds. People, aliens, AIs. The first life you take is hard. The second one is harder. Then after that, you forget whatever it was that made it tough in the first place. But then one day, you come face to face with the other side, and it bites back. My unit was ordered to bomb a Chig C-3 tower. The LZ was hot with AAG, so I ordered we set him down and do it, just like the old Corps. On the ground, things got real hairy. I felt they cheesed up, got scared, said they wanted to wait for reinforcements. So I left them. Ditched them here. Went in, did it by myself. On the way back, I could hear they were under fire. They call it the Mad Minute. Desperately firing at anything. A violent prayer that you could kill enough of the enemy so you could get out. And I've killed before. Close enough so I can see that look in the target's eyes. That moment when they know that they have one horrified heartbeat left to live. I never knew how sacred that moment was. Until I saw it in the lives that I was responsible for. Look what they've done. Chigs are afraid of their dead. Horrified of ours. Remove the eyes and the heart.
But all that crap means nothing. The finest spirits, six unequaled souls, are gone. And that's because of me. So I came back to lay them to rest, because that's how we do it in the Corps. That's the least I can do for them and their families. And unfortunately, it seems like all I can do for me.
You shouldn't have left them.
They should have gone with me. The final Marine that we laid to rest is Robert Joseph Grant. He grew up in Syracuse, New York. He has a wife, Karen, and three children. Bob said if he could choose how he would die, that he would go down Black Hole while listening to Johnny Cash. Now, I'm not much for Johnny Cash, but, well, that's how he wanted to go. Science types say anyone entering a black hole would be pulled in every direction. That time would be so distorted that the last second of a person's life would never come. Bob wanted to believe that you could survive it, even go back in time, or forward, or cross over to another universe, a place where you could look in on this one from time to time. He may have died in a much less glorious fashion, but I believe, I have to believe right now, that he lives on in each of these possibilities. I believe they all do. You were wrong that night in the bunks, Vanson. Some people like me are born mean. But you were also right. Because there are some things that happen that make them meaner. Now let's get those planes.
Sensors say they're operational. The planes are scattered about 15 degrees from each other.
Everybody stripped down to flight gear. If the Chigs knew they were here, they would have destroyed them. When we start them up, they'll be all over our tails. All right. You all know your assignments. Nothing fancy. Just get back to the hammerheads and take off. Now, once we get off this stinking cesspool, the flight path back to the Saratoga requires passage near the Cerberus Black Hole. Now, you gotta look alive for two reasons. First, that sucker's got a mass 20 times larger than our sun, and the hammerheads do not have the thrust to withstand the gravitational pull up to 500,000 miles, so stay clear. And second, the Chig fighters have a capability of skipping across the black hole wash. This is the hole. This is the Cerberus wash. This is no man's land. They have these red fighters. Chigs can cut across here, cutting off your flight path by 250,000 miles. And then they come out ahead of you. That can be a real brick passer. Unless you're ready. One more thing. I never got a chance to tell my friends goodbye. Odds are some of you aren't going to come back. Don't spend a whole life regretting.
Goodbye. If there is a heaven, I hope the Niners aren't in its Super Bowl.
6 years isn't a long time to be alive. But I'm glad I got to spend it with you guys, some of it.
Au revoir. À tout à l'heure.
I hope you find her.
Bye. I know I speak for all of us, Colonel. I can't say it was great serving under you, but we all hope to see you on the other side.
What are you talking to me for? I ain't gonna die. I'll be point. I'm taking Bob's plane. Move out!
Computer check. Master arm switch safe.
IR cooling switch off.
Altitude reference indicator uncaged. Clearance 580. Clearance on request. Flow is joint.
Wild Guard, this is Deuce. Cerberus, 100 KSMs, 3 o'clock. Maintain position. Home base is 500 KSMs.
This is Ace. Got two bogeys, 5 o'clock. There's a whole squadron coming in from behind them.
We got bigger problems straight ahead. Closing fast. They're boxing us in.
About you guys, but there's a Bears-Lions game on Sunday I don't intend to miss.
I'll take the Lions. And 2 points for every chig.
You're on.
I got your 6. That's a kill.
Good shooting, 5-8. Target approaching, 9 o'clock.
I'm on.
Nice one, Coop!
They've locked on to me.
Hoorah!
I'm still reading 2 bandits at 5 o'clock in the wash. Confirm?
They're corralling us to the black hole so the red bandits can jump us. This intercept angle, we will not have enough fuel to maneuver when they hit.
Let's take them on. Red bandits are worth 3 points.
Negative. They're in the wash. We cannot engage.
If we don't EA, we're going to be target practice for these chicks.
What do you advise, Deuce? Repeat. What do you advise?
Just fly tight. Your hammerheads can outrun their fighters, and y'all won't have to worry about the red bandits.
Negative, Colonel. If you go in, you can't get out.
If anybody can wax their tails and pull out of the wash, it's Lieutenant Colonel Raymond T. Butts. Pancake time.
Now get out of there!
Come on. Come on, you son of a... Come on, darling. Don't let me go. Come on. Don't follow me now, darling. Come on. Son of a... Come on!
Burn him!
Go give it all!
I'm out of fuel. Well, I guess Ray Butts has ate his last pancake. It has been an honor, 5-8.
Goodbye, sir.
Semper Fi, Mac.
Right.
Ride it for Bob.
I keep a close watch on this heart. Watch it fly wide open. Watch it fly wide.
Saratoga, this is the 58th returning. Minus one. Requesting permission to dock.
Roger that. Permission granted, 58th.
Cruise commence diagnostics, fuel, and repair. Welcome back, wild cards.
Welcome back. I had the galley make up something special for you. It'll be in the mess when you get cleaned up.
Watch your hands, watch your hands.